In this video, we will try to understand a new optimization algorithm, that is Cheetah Optimizer. What is Quantum Cat and Dingo optimization? We already discussed in previous videos. Now we will discuss what is Cheetah optimization algorithm. Cheetah optimizer is basically inspired by the natural hunting behavior of cheetahs in real life. And this algorithm is designed to solve large-scale optimization problems. And even we can use this algorithm to solve multi-objective optimization problems. And Cheetah Optimizer provides efficient results when it is compared with meta-heuristic different algorithms, including hybrid algorithms. This algorithm performance is much better than other. So we can use this algorithm to solve a number of optimization problems. So as you can see here, it is introduced in 2022, and the inspiration behind this algorithm is the hunting techniques used by cheetahs in real life for their survival, and we can use this to solve a number of optimization problems. In this video, we will discuss what is Cheetah Optimizer, how this algorithm works, different mathematical models used in this algorithm, and we will try to understand this algorithm step by step with different examples. So we'll use here different examples to understand the working of this algorithm. And you can see the applications of this algorithm. We can use this algorithm to solve routing problems, scheduling problems, resource allocation problems. And real world applications, you can see in cloud computing, we can apply this for the resource allocation, in manufacturing for the scheduling, and for optimizing the supply chain management. So as this algorithm is inspired by the cheetahs hunting techniques, so first we will try to understand few facts about cheetahs, their behavior, and different techniques they use for their survival in real life, so that we can easily understand how this algorithm is working, because this algorithm simulates different hunting techniques used by cheetahs in real life. So this algorithm is simulating these techniques to find out the optimal solution. So about cheetahs, as we know, that is the one of the fastest land animal, and you can see in the image on their body we have different spots. They typically have a yellowish tan coat with black spots, which help them to mix into the environment. And here you can see on their face their distinctive tear marks. You can see here the tear marks run from their inner corner of the eyes to the down to side of their mouth. And about the speed, you can see it is 97 to 113 kilometer per hour, and diet they are carnivores obviously. And about the hunting behavior, they use different hunting techniques, like they stalk the target, sit and bait for the target, chase it, attack, and other that we will discuss step by step now. Now we will see different hunting strategies they use. So in this algorithm, multiple hunting strategies are implemented. And you know, when this algorithm is simulated, we have the virtual environment, virtual cheetahs, virtual target. So the hunting time is here the maximum number of iterations. You know, the meta-heuristic algorithm explore the search space iteratively. After that, they give us the solution. So here we have the hunting time, that is the hunting time for the cheetah, that is the maximum number of iterations used in this algorithm. Now you can see different hunting strategies they are used by the cheetahs. First we have searching, sit and wait, attack, leave the prey, and go back home. First we have the search mode. Search mode in this algorithm is used as the exploration phase, where the search agents will explore the search space to find out the optimal solution. Now in the search mode, the cheetah is looking for the target, and here the prey, that is the target, it can be found when the cheetah is roaming or observing its surrounding. And next we have sit and wait mode. So when cheetah spot its prey, cheetah may choose to wait for the prey to approach for attacking. So in real life, when cheetah spot any prey, they sit quietly, that is sit and wait. They sit and wait for the prey to approach before attack, because if cheetah attack all sudden, there is a chance of prey escape or run away. So they sit and wait for the prey before attack. So finally, when the cheetah spot the target, They sit quietly and wait for the target to come closer. And when the target is coming closer, they prepare themselves for the attack. The third strategy we have attack. When the target is now closer to cheetah, they will decide attack. Attack mode in this algorithm is simulated as the exploitation phase. Before attack, cheetah analyzes the target location, conditions, distance between them. When cheetahs attack, they use high speed and flexible physique to move quickly and block the prey. So here in the attack mode, we have two phases, rush and capture. You know, when the cheetah is attacking on the target, it is quite obvious that the target may try to escape. The target will try here its best to escape, and sometimes there is failure in hunt. If attack fails, cheetah return to home and regain its energy before new hunt. And for a variety of reasons, cheetah may give up hunting. If cheetah is running out of energy or they have a fast target that run away, then they give up the hunt. So in this case, cheetah go back home and rest. They regain their energy before new hunt. So these four simple cheetah's hunting strategies are simulated in this algorithm to find out the optimal solution for the complex optimization problems. First, we have search mode, that is the exploration phase in this algorithm. Here, global search is done by the agents. Then we have second strategy, that is sit and wait. Attack mode, that is the exploitation phase. Now you can see different steps used in this algorithm. Now, step by step, we will try to understand how this algorithm is working. So first, we will define all the important parameters. Then, we will initialize the population randomly in the search space. Using objective function, calculate the fitness value for each individual in the current population. Then, we will initialize the population, home, leader, and the target, that is prey. We will repeat the loop until stopping criteria is met. And the stopping criteria, we have the maximum iterations. So loop will repeat till the maximum iteration. After that, it will display the best solution. So inside the main loop of this algorithm, first we will select the value for M. M, that is the members of cheetahs randomly selected. So randomly selected cheetahs, we will denote it with M. After that, for each member 1 to M, we will perform here, that is define the neighbor agent and calculate these random values. After that, we will normally distribute 4 random values, R2, R3, H and R4. These random values are used to perform different hunting techniques used by cheetahs. Here you can see R2 is compared with R3. If condition is not true, then we will go inside the loop. Here we will compare H with R4. Then we will perform either attack or search. Now we have sit and wait strategy. Then we will update the new leader, then update the new solution, leader, calculate the fitness values, increment the counter. Then we will apply here the last strategy, leave the prey and go back home. When the stopping criteria is met, stop and display the solution. Here you can see how it is working. Here you can see, just compare the random values and accordingly we will perform sit and wait, search and attack strategy. Then update the prey and the leader. Now let's try to understand how this algorithm is working step by step. First, we will initialize the parameters. Parameters like we have here, population size. That is the total number of search agents we are using here. Search agents, suppose here we have the cheetahs. So we have the virtual environment, virtual search agents, virtual search space. Done. So then we will select the members, that is cheetahs, randomly, that is noted with M. Define the number, how much they are selected. Then we have the dimension. Define the dimension, that is also known as the design variables of your problem. Current iteration, maximum number of iteration, and if you have any other data of your optimization problem, you can define this. After that, we will initialize the population for the search agents. Now suppose here we have just 3 search agents, and we are using here the dimension 10. It means suppose we have 10 design variables. You know what is search space in meta-heuristic algorithm? That refers to the number of variables or parameters that define potential solution to the optimization problem you are trying to solve. For example, if you have just a single optimization problem with single variable, then you have to find out the minimum value. Then if you have just one design variable, it means the search space would be one dimensional that define each potential solution. And in complex optimization problems, search space can be multi-dimensional. It means that each potential solution is represented by a set of design variables. You can see here design variables on the dimension d1, d2, d3 up to dn. It depends how many dimension or the design variables you have. If it is just one, it means the search space is one dimensional. And if you have multiple design variables, it means you have the multi-dimensional search space. Here you can see we have cheetahs. It can be 1, 2, 3 up to n. And here you can see we have design variable 1 to n. You can use any number of design variables. It depends what type of optimization problem you are solving. Here each individual 1, 2, 3 up to n, each individual in the population represent a potential solution to the optimization problem. And here the potential solution is characterized by a set of design variables. So here we are using 10 design variables and we have 3 search agents. And each individual, that is each cheetah in the population, is a potential solution. And here you can see the range for each. We have lower bound -5, upper bound that is 5. All the values are within the bound, that is the search space boundary. So in cheetah optimizer, we have multiple cheetahs. They are hunting prey, and each prey represent a potential solution to the optimization problem. So we'll consider the prey as the optimal solution because all the cheetahs are looking for the target. So here cheetah's aim is to find the best prey among them. That is the optimal solution. Here you can see we have different state for the cheetahs, such as their positions or their movements during hunt. This is represented by candidate solutions. Or we can say the individual within the optimization algorithm population. So in this algorithm, each cheetah explores a different part of search space that is represented by prey location. This is similar to how individual in other optimization algorithm explore different regions of the solution space. So maybe the first cheetah is doing the search, it means he's searching for the target. Here we will apply the first strategy. Maybe second one is doing sit and wait, second strategy. Another one is doing the attack. So here each cheetah is characterized by its current position, which correspond to particular solution within search space. Prey is here the potential solution within the optimization problem space, and each prey is candidate solution that other cheetahs are attempting to find. And when we say we have many prey, means there are multiple potential solutions scattered throughout the optimization problem space. And in cheetah optimizer, these prey represent various points in solution space that algorithm serves to explore in its search for the optimal solution. In this algorithm, we will use the objective function and we will evaluate each potential solution to determine its quality, that is fitness. So we're using the objective function to calculate the fitness value for each agent, and then we will evaluate their quality. And this algorithm iteratively explore and evaluate different prey, that is the candidate solution, in search of the best solution, that is the optimal solution. So the goal of this algorithm is to find and converge the word best prey among all. So first define the parameters, then initialize the population. Suppose we have 3 agents, then we are using here 10 design variables. So accordingly, we will define here the individual's position in the search space, and then Here, we will use the objective function to calculate the fitness value for each individual in the current population. That's how we will evaluate their quality. And we will update the best solution and the global best solution. After that, we will initialize the population home, leader, and prey. Leader is here the best solution, and the prey, that is the global best solution. The main loop for this algorithm start, we will select m members of cheetahs randomly, then we will define the neighbors, and for each arrangement we will calculate the value for randomization parameter, turning factor, step length, interaction factor, and the random value. And after that, we will choose here the random numbers to perform different hunting strategies: attack, search, sit, attack, search. So we will compare the random values. If R2 is greater than R3, then we'll perform sit and wait. Else, we will go search and attack. Then we will update the prey and the leader. Now, first case, suppose the condition is false here, and we compare H with R4, and H is greater than, suppose, R4. The first, we have the search mode. In the search mode, that is the exploration phase in this algorithm. So in search mode, as we already discussed, the target can be spotted, or it is when the cheetah is actively moving in the dimensional search space, it can found the target. So in cheetah's population, each prey location is given by the best decision variable. So in this step, the position for the cheetah is calculated by using its current position in arrangement J, and here we have a randomization parameter. Then we are using here the step length. Here this step length varies according to the distance of the current cheetah from its neighbor. Its current cheetah is not leader, then we will calculate the value for step length using this equation: 0.01 into current iteration divided by maximum iteration. And here we have current cheetah position minus random cheetah position. And in case if the current cheetah is leader, then we'll calculate the value for alpha using this equation: 0.01 into current iteration divided by maximum iteration into maximum step length. So if any opponent appear, the leader will change its direction. So in the search mode, you can see how the position is updated for the cheetahs. Next we have here attack mode. Here you can see how we can update the agent's position in the attack mode. This is the new position, that is the next position for the cheetah. And here you can see this is the best position, that is the current best position. Again, we have a randomization factor that we can calculate using this. Then we will calculate the step length, and here we have step length, that is the current best position minus agent's current position. So here you can see the step length is calculated here. So here each cheetah updates its position around the prey position. So this step helps the algorithm to find the near optimal solution faster, and it also increases the convergence speed. So using this equation, we can calculate the attack mode for the agents. Else we have sit and wait. In sit and wait, you can see the cheetah is not moving, so its next position is equal to its current position. So cheetah's position is not changed, it remains same, and it is looking for the better solution, and this helped them to avoid premature convergence. And last one, we have leave the prey and go back home. In case if there is failure during hunt, then cheetah will go back home and rest to regain its energy to start new hunt. So here the position of the cheetah is changed to the current position of the prey. So here the leader position is set equal to the position of the best solution. And then we will reset the hunting time, that is the current iteration 0, and also reset the position of other cheetahs, and then we will repeat the loop. Increment the counter, and then we will repeat the loop. When the stopping criteria is met, we'll stop and display the best solution. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.